Do not attempt the training techniques you are about to see without consulting a professional. Tonight on Cesar 911, Cesar gets a call for help from comedian Jerry Seinfeld.
Hey!
How you doing?
I'm beloved by millions. Come here. Every one dog. The hostility, that I don't deserve.
And his other dog has its own set of issues.
When the doorbell rings, Jose will go crazy, just barking, 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 barking.
And then, a dog-friendly community is put in a constant state of fright by one of its own.
The worst case scenario is that, God forbid he bite my dog, he's gonna be in big trouble. I personally will call animal control.
Making his owners outcasts in their own neighborhood.
Animals have been taken away from me too.
This is Cesar 911. Cesar receives a call from good friend and comedy legend Jerry Seinfeld. Jerry informs Cesar that he's having problems with his two dachshunds, Jose and Foxy. And one of them in particular is creating an issue in the house. And it's no laughing matter.
Hey!
How you doing?
Really good, man. You look great.
So I hear you're in New York.
Yes. Look at me. Three coats, two shirts. I am in New York.
You're a little girl. I told you I have these two little dogs.
Yes.
And I'm having a little problem. You said you're going to help me.
What's the problem?
Problem is one of the dogs intensely dislikes me. She'll let me near her if she's with someone that she feels safe with.
Right.
But she also doesn't like any other adult males either.
So she won't like me either?
Well, I don't know if you're that much of an adult.
That's true. All right, well, I can stop by.
Great. I'm here.
All right. Let's do it. I'll see you in a few.
Okay. Looking forward to it. I'm beloved by millions. Except for one dog.
This is the one?
Oh, this is the good one.
Oh, this is the
this
one.
This is the good son.
Jerry said, this is the good dog. I can't wait to see the bad one.
She's terrified. She's trembling. What do you think I should do? She's a wreck.
You have a leash?
Yeah.
Let's put a leash on.
Okay. After our cats died, I thought I wasn't ready to get any more cats. So we got dogs. And little dogs, because little dogs in New York City are a lot easier.
In the city, you can't have big dogs. I don't like large excrement. Doesn't suit my lifestyle.
We first got Jose.
Jose has always been very affectionate. He loves being a Seinfeld. And that's the kind of people we like. We like people that are with the program.
But he has a lot of energy. When the doorbell rings, Jose will go crazy, just barking, 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 barking. And then we go outside, and then he starts barking at everyone who passes us by. Woo!
Wow, what a well-trained dog.
Wouldn't that be nice? I don't know how to make him stop. So we thought maybe he seemed like he needed a friend, so we got Foxy. When we got her home, she definitely seemed nervous.
I thought any dog likes who their owner is, assuming the owner is basically functioning. Food, walking, playing a little bit. I assume that. I was wrong.
Foxy and I have a good relationship, but she has no interest in being friends with Jerry whatsoever.
Fox, come here, Fox.
The minute Jerry tried to go near her, she would just, you know, run away or hide.
You go over to her to be nice to her, to pet her, and she takes off.
Foxy, come here. Come here. Come here. Come on. Say hi.
I'm pretty disappointed that that there is no gratitude at all. Of course, she doesn't understand that I'm the one that's paying for all this. Obviously, that's beyond her little marble brain capacity. But the antipathy, the hostility, that I don't deserve.
At this point, we sort of don't know why we got her. And that's a terrible way to think of an animal. I think that Jerry at this point has written her off. And I think there's a way to salvage this relationship. If not just salvage, hopefully make it somewhat better. Watch this.
Okay. Well, the pupils are very dilated. Yeah, so she's terrified, yeah.
Here's where I feel really bad. Because this poor guy, Cesar Milan, who has fixed every dog he's ever met, he's not going to fix this dog. When he leaves, he's going to be in tears. Because he's gonna have to say to me, I'm sorry, there was nothing I could do. This is a one messed up dog. This dog is a sick puppy.
Hold her for 1 second while I get her leash.
Okay.
You never
know.
It's
not gonna help her. Okay. Actually, it's better.
Okay.
It's better if you hold it than she holds it, because she's gonna give affection and you're gonna ask her to face what she's afraid of. You know, in life you have to face things,
yeah.
We like it or not.
Right.
But if we stay away from it, we never really learn anything.
Right.
And so
who's facing them, me or her?
Her. Jessica nurtures her insecurity.
Okay.
By being with you, you actually challenge the insecurity.
Right.
You know, so right. I know it's the opposite in the dog-loving world because they say, well, she doesn't like it, that, so it's best if she stays with me.
Right.
But then you mentally never move forward.
I see. Did you hear this, Jess?
Yeah.
If she spends more time with me, she'll face...
Get over it.
Yeah. Get over it a
get
little.
Get over it, right.
But I can never get... I can get to her this way. If
yeah.
Jess is holding her,
yeah.
Then I can hold her. But she
well,
wouldn't let me...
I'm going to show you... I'm going to show you, like, ways where you can stop the flight.
Right.
So a dog that is insecure or fearful, they're going to flight. They're going to hide.
Right.
So how do we block the brain so the brain can actually move forward?
Okay.
So we're just going to learn a little bit of that, and then you build on that.
Fox is an insecure dog that finds it hard to bond with anyone but Jessica. And Jerry is feeling rejected and frustrated. I'm going to use the leash as a tool to help Foxy overcome some of her insecurities. All right, let's go and have a chat. Now, my goal here is for her just to move a little bit, just to make one step forward so I can close the gap. All right, so here, we're just gonna ask very little. Well, if you give affection right now, you're giving her affection when she's actually retrieving.
Right.
So your affection is nurturing that very thing that you don't like. When you nurture a dog's insecure behavior, you're only encouraging that behavior to continue. You're not helping it.
Will you admit at this point that this is not an easy puzzle?
Right. No, insecure dogs, just like insecure people, you have to build self-esteem before you actually help them to get rid of the problem. It's easier to rehabilitate an aggressive dog than an insecure dog, because at least an aggressive dog wants to be with you.
Involved. Yes.
He wants to be in your personal space.
Right.
This one wants to be away from your personal space.
So Jerry thinks that this is going to be the one.
No, it just
no,
thinks.
Nothing he can
no, no, now no. You know. Now you see.
I knew. I knew.
Now
I
you see. There's joking. Not.
Yeah,
this is only.
But it's tricky.
There you go.
This is a tricky little there. Dog.
The first step for Foxy is for her to take just one step towards me.
Until she moves a little forward, then I can say the word that it means good girl. Okay, let's do it again. There you go, that's a good girl. Just the fact that she's moving forward. There you go, there you go. There you go.
There you go.
That's a good girl. Yeah, that's a good girl. Yeah, that's a good, that's a good. There you go. You gotta unlock the brain. But once the brain realizes, all right, this tension doesn't mean harm. It just means to, it just means for me to move forward in life.
Right away, Foxy responded to just calmness, and it ended up being something that was exactly right for her.
So this is all her decision right there.
Right.
So just for her to face, to try to figure it out other ways. Then she learns, all right, this is what that guy wants. He just wants me to move towards him. That's all I want. And every time I move towards him, he celebrates. I'm inviting her to come near my intimate space. Look at that. Yeah.
That was amazing.
Absolutely.
Can you believe this?
Foxy needed to build her self-confidence. Once we block her ability for flight, she had to face her fear of men. We started at 3 feet away, then we moved to 2 feet away, eventually 1 foot, then all the way to my leg. We're making progress.
Okay, so don't pat her.
No, yes, you can. Okay. Yeah, because it's a reward. Uh-huh. She just went through a lot right now.
Yeah.
Come here.
Especially if Jerry rewards, has a better effect. She expects for you. She trusts you more than he trusts him.
So he should reward her.
Yeah, yeah.
I couldn't be in a better setup than this. I got Cesar Millan and my misbehaving dog. Yeah, it's like watching Roger Federer play tennis. It's just, or watching, Mario Batali cook. It's just like, this is a beautiful thing.
Cesar is making progress with Foxy's insecurities inside the apartment. But now, he wants to bring the family outside to continue this rehabilitation.
With her leading the pack and being in front of all these people, it's actually good. Yeah, we want her to build a little bit of that self-esteem a little bit. Yeah.
By having Jessica walk Foxy in front of the pack, it will help both dogs improve their behavior.
There you go. Little bit. There you go, it's coming. There you go. See that little bit of pressure right there, then she relaxes. As soon as she goes and says, let's go, then that's when you can say, let's go.
Cesar was called by Jerry Seinfeld, whose dachshund Foxy isn't showing love and affection towards him. Progress is being made slowly.
There you go. That's a good girl.
To help Foxy with her insecurity issue, Cesar puts her at the front of the pack.
Little bit. There you go. It's coming. There you go. There you go. It's a lot.
Jerry might have thought that we only have one dog to help. But when I came to his home this morning, I knew we actually have two dogs with issues.
Amen.
Jose gets excited both at the house and on our walk. We need Jerry and his family to recognize when Jose is starting to get worked up and stop him correctly.
When they go into alert state, the head goes a little high.
So as soon as Jose goes into that alert state,
you stop the brain from escalating.
As soon as she goes into the alert state, you stop her from escalating taking hold a little bit, firm, not tense.
It's like when you ride in a horse.
Your reins.
And you do this a little bit. That's it. You just tell the horse, come this way.
You get them on the bit. Yeah.
You send them back to where you want them to be. Right there. Then this guy, and then they pass by. That's another option.
See that? That was great.
Your turn, Jerry.
Okay.
Jerry needs to learn to walk Jose past other dogs so he can handle the situation in the future.
That's too much tension.
Too much?
Yeah. Sure, there you go. You felt it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It really doesn't have to feel tension unless the dog is about to misbehave.
Right.
99% of the time, it's almost... If I have to feel like feather, like you're just holding a leash.
Yeah. But just you're not having contact.
Yeah, that's it. Right there. There you go. Nice. He moved away. Nice. Bring it back to follow you. Turn out the leash. There. That's all it is. Nice. Nice. There you go. There you go. Nice.
That's how you become a leader.
No more barking at the park unless you want it.
Now I know how to do it. You put your hand like that. You project a strong energy of control. And you make this little sound. And it does something to him. I don't know. I don't even know how it works. You know, that's the pack leader thing. You're showing them I'm in charge here.
That was a pit bull, by the way.
She just went after the pit bull.
Because she's in front.
And they'll stop.
You had the body language of a person who doesn't walk a dog a lot. He's walking like this, look. Look, his shoulders up. Relax, arm relax, because that's what you're feeding. Mm-hmm. You know, you're feeding the energy. Sure, not tense.
Energy. This was the first time I knew what is the right technique for walking a dog. Because you see people with dogs on leashes. Now I'm going to want to stop them all and go, you know, you're doing that wrong. That's wrong. Stop what you're doing. That's going to be a problem.
The Seinfelds are making progress towards helping Foxy with her insecurities. But Jose needs to be taught how to handle all his energy at the house.
What I'm going to do right now is somebody's going to knock on the door, they're going to ring the bell. Okay, and he's going to go and bark at the door.
Right.
Yes?
Yes.
So the first thing he has to learn is... The human claims that ritual. Remember, you're working with excitement that turns into dominance. We already did it outside. It's the same thing. He was barking at dogs, now he's barking at the door.
Yeah.
It's the same thing. It's just a different object that he's barking to. We're just going to transfer what he just learned.
This is one of the most common problems that dog owners face. And I'm going to show them how to take control of it.
I like the slide at the end.
Not yet. It's settled. There you go. So if he moves away without coming down, then he didn't learn anything. He has to move away when he calms down.
Just as Jose started barking at the door, I gave him a correction, and I did not allow him to leave until he reached a calm, submissive state.
If he moves out of the door when he's excited, we still have an excited brain.
If we what?
So he moves to the door, right?
Yeah.
And then I come in, I stop him, and I give him some time. You have to calm down, you have to wait. And he goes, it's normal, because he's venting.
Right.
But he's going down. Once he settles down, then you release the pressure.
I see.
Then he associates that, oh, okay, so when that guy comes and do this, what he wants is for my brain to be calm. That's when he releases the pressure.
So how many more of these you think?
Well, let's see. Let's go.
To prevent him from charging the door, I'm physically going to block Jose and give him a correction. I'm going to start with halfway to the door. Next, I'm going to cut him off just a few feet away from the stairs. And finally, I'm going to correct him while he's still on the stairs. Jose will eventually learn to be less excited and learn how to deal with the Seinfeld's guest.
One more.
Cesar is helping Jerry and Jessica Seinfeld's two dogs, who have opposite problems. Foxy needs to gain self-confidence, while Jose needs to learn how to stay calm.
One more. Now the brain is not moving. We have the barking, but not the moving.
Right.
Once Jose understood what the correct behavior was, he immediately got it. Strong leadership is key to a well-behaved dog.
Because he's already associated with me, that's not what I want. Their goal is to make you happy.
Right.
That's it. That's all they want. How do they make you happy? You have to show them how.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But the only way they can learn is if you teach it in a calm, confident way.
You know, most people, when they want to control a dog, they yell at the dog. When they don't get the result they want, they get more agitated. And I didn't realize how that's completely counterproductive.
So what did we learn today?
It is a combination of our calm yet our assertiveness that's going to make them both happier dogs and more secure dogs. Yep.
And with her, to trust. That we have a little distance to go with that.
This is trust, this is respect. To respect right. What you say.
Right.
Respectful.
When you watch people with a well-trained dog, you just don't even know how that happened. It's like when someone does a card trick and you go, I don't know how that happened. But then someone shows you the mechanics of it and it's doable. So, very exciting.
So, the nice new homework you guys gonna do is just put a leash on Foxy, do what I did with her, and then the doorbell.
The Seinfelds have two assignments for homework. I want Jerry to use the leash with Foxy to help her become more confident around him. Second, I want Jessica to work on correcting Jose before he gets too excited by the doorbell. It's important that the Seinfelds work in what I taught them if they really want to change their dog's behavior. After all, you can change a dog in one day.
I thought there was going to be more homework. I'm very pleased with the light homework.
I just want to start doing the homework all the time. Mm-hmm. And I just want to get to a totally different place. And I feel like Cesar gave us incredible tools.
Well, thank you for having me in your house.
Oh, we loved having you.
I can't wait to see the progress in your dog.
Right.
All right.
Thank you.
As long as Jessica and Jerry do their homework, both of their dogs have a chance to behave better with the family.
Thank you.
We love you.
A few days later, Cesar receives videos from Jerry and Jessica with an update.
Hi, Cesar. I'm here in Central Park with Jose and Foxy. We had a great walk with no barking, no barking at other dogs, no barking when we came out of the elevator. Everything we worked on worked like a charm. Had the greatest time, and I have all these new things that I'm working on with them to have a much more pleasant walk.
Okay, Cesar, I'm here with Foxy, and we are working through our issues. And look at that, she just laid down on me, which she has never done in the 3 years that we've had her. So we just got somewhere right there.
Cesar will check in on the Seinfelds to see if they continue their good progress. Cesar's next call brings him back to California to meet whistleblowers Betty, Pam, and Cynthia, who live in a dog-friendly condo complex. Their neighbors Susan and Chirene's terrier mix named Lucky is frightening the whole community.
Hello, ladies.
Hi. Hi.
What's your name?
Betty.
Pam.
Nice to meet you.
There you go. That's awesome. I love to be around so many ladies and dogs. That's the best part of it.
This is our condo complex. It's in Fountain Valley, California. And there's 164 units and approximately 75 dogs. We get together every week. We walk our dogs.
We have doggy parades. We have little happy hours, and we invite people with their dogs. Our community is a dog lover's dream.
So, how can I help you?
Our neighbor, Susan, has a dog named Lucky.
Mm-hmm.
Lucky has bitten dogs as well as people, and we would love your help.
Lucky is ferocious. I mean, he's scary. He's very scary.
No! Lucky! Hey!
And Lola got attacked a year ago. He latched onto her knee. She needed stitches. And every time Lola sees Lucky, they just, like, growl at each other, and Lucky lunges at her.
Susan did not really believe that it had happened.
That's almost like a denial type of thing.
Yes, denial for sure.
That's more challenging than an aggressive dog, okay? A denial?
Lucky runs the household. Not Susan, not Cherie. Lucky's the master. They are his servants. They've got that backwards.
Their dog's a rescue.
Okay.
And
that doesn't mean anything.
I know. But they don't know that. He was abused, and they make excuses for his bad behavior.
Yes.
They do. And they baby him. And they think his bad behavior is because of what he's gone through rather than what they're doing to him right now.
And they're a very nice family.
They really are.
And they can't walk with us.
Yeah, as soon as we see them walk Lucky, we walk the opposite way.
All of us.
Lucky has turned Susan into an outcast of our community. She wants to walk with us, and she can't. It's not that we don't want her, we just don't want Lucky. The worst case scenario with Lucky is that he bites another person, he bites another dog. God forbid he bite my dog, he's gonna be in big trouble. I personally will call animal control to put him down. It's nothing personal. It's for the safety of our community.
She should be coming down with Lucky in a minute now. Right. So if you want to, we can go over there and you'll see what happens.
Let's go, ladies.
My picture perfect scenario, at the end of this process, I would love to see Susan and Lucky walk with us.
Betty leads Cesar to the courtyard, where he can get a first-hand view of Lucky's behavior.
Easy, easy, Lucky. Easy, easy, boy.
Oh, bad. Yeah, that's pretty bad, you're right.
Cesar was called by concerned residents in a dog-friendly community to help their neighbor, Shireen, and her menacing terrier mix, Lucky. They've arranged for Cesar to watch Shireen and Lucky's walk.
Pretty bad, you're right. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Nice to meet you, Cesar.
Oh my God, Cesar's here.
I was called to help you here.
Cesar Milan comes out of nowhere
He says, hi, I'm Cesar Milan, I'm here to train you, and I felt a sigh of relief.
Miss Susan, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
This is lucky.
Look, this is good. I want you to learn about dogs.
My name is Susan Itamadi.
And my name is Shrina Tamadi. And our dog, Lucky, is the outcast of the community. He's a problem in our neighborhood. We've never had a dog before. This is our first dog. I dreamt of having one my entire life. My friend found Lucky. The state that he was in, you can see his ribs, malnourished. So you can tell there was some sort of abuse going on with him.
It just broke my heart to see him in this condition. And when I saw him, I fell in love with him. The moment I saw him, he just put his head on my lap and I said, I promise God, this is his mine and I'm gonna take care of him for the rest of my life. I love you, bro. When we brought him home, he gave us such a hard time. He would bite, he would growl, he would try to scratch. He doesn't obey any of our commands.
No biting.
So he was very aggressive from the beginning with dogs and human beings.
We've had instances where Lucky's gotten away from the leash and has physically harmed another dog and a person.
No, 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 no! No! Lucky!
Our heart sank right then because we don't want anything happen to other dog.
It just felt unreal.
I don't want them to hurt any dogs. I don't want him to be taken away from me, too.
It sucks when you finally get your first dog and you can't even be part of your own dog community in your own neighborhood. We feel like we're the outcasts in our neighborhood. It's not a pleasant feeling to have, especially when you've been so close to all your neighbors for such a long time. There is a dog parade next weekend. Lucky's never been invited to a dog parade before, but we would like to see him. We want to feel like we're part of a community again. We're desperate to get help.
You rescue him, right? Yeah. It's a rescue.
Yeah.
With dogs that are rescued, a lot of people, they feel sorry for the dog.
It's true.
Right? And then when you feel sorry for the dog, your energy is weak.
Yeah.
It's not strong. And so the dog compensates the leadership. So right now when I approach, his whole demeanor changed. Look, see, backing down, that. So here, me, confident. So what he's doing right now, by me approaching a little confident, is he switches.
Okay.
Now I'm going to show you, okay? I got to put the leash on. The harness is not as helpful when you want to lead a dog. The first thing I need to do is to change Lucky's harness to a slip leash. Harnesses encourage pulling behavior, which is the last thing we want. The slip leash helps to control the dog's head better, which encourages him to follow. You're going to be right here,
okay. And
you and I, we're going to walk together.
After putting the new leash on Lucky, Cesar demonstrates the right way to lead him.
So watch the difference, okay?
Okay.
He is next to me, not in front of me.
Okay.
So that's going to alone change his perception, the way he sees the world. When Lucky walks in front, it's like asking him to be in patrol and protect Cherie. Moving him to the side will make him feel less protective. Go ahead, send me the dog.
I'm so nervous because I don't know if he's going to, you know, run off the leash and go attack him.
Right. Same dog barking, but he's not barking.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
All right. Lucky's bad behavior is being encouraged. Whenever Shireen puts him in the lead, once we change this, he's able to cope when another dog passes by. So here, we're going to pass by this dog's right here. I want you to watch. So I'm leading him to this scenario right here.
look.
I had like a sinking feeling in my heart, like something is about to happen.
That's fine. I want the parking lot right here. Look. He's a little bit unsure, but more calm. So now, look, right here, look. Address right there. Very good. When we approached the other dogs, Lucky was unsure because his tail was low and he was shaking his head. That's the time to give a correction. He responded immediately. And that tells me that Lucky just needs a strong leader. So here, I'm asking him to be in front of all this excitement and stay calm. As a parent, we have to project confidence,
okay,
to our children. If as a parent we project insecurity, that's what we're going to steal in our children.
It's true.
Now it's Shireen's turn. She needs to show her neighbors that she can be in control. That's the first step. So short, not tense. I'm having her start by using a gentle leader, which is like training wheels. It gives her a greater control. At the moment he moves towards, you just pull up. And as soon as you pull up, the brain stops. The gentle leader is a great tool. But eventually, I need to see her controlling Lucky without it. You have to stay focused. So this is an obstacle course.
Right.
So what you're saying is, go through everything and pay attention to me only.
Okay, I got it.
All right, go ahead. Okay, same
grass.
Same area, yeah. Not tense, not anxious, nothing. Just commanding, confidence, assertiveness.
Cesar is teaching Shireen how to properly walk Lucky past dogs from her neighborhood. This is an important first step in managing Lucky.
All right, go ahead. Right there, sit him down.
Sit.
Not strong enough. That's why it's not working.
Sit.
There you go. Shireen did a much better job keeping Lucky calm. His tail was in a confident position. Shireen was able to walk right past the other dogs without incident. But when it came time to tell Lucky to sit, her voice commands were way too weak.
Sit.
So we still have some work to do before she's ready to handle the parade. So what you just did right now is tell him to wait, even though they are in an excited state.
Mm-hmm. Because I don't want him to be
That's
in an
right.
excited state.
So you say, we're going to wait while they're going through this excitement.
Right.
So here, this is awesome right
this
here.
This is good. I can give him affection because I'm rewarding him.
This is when you give affection, people. Don't give affection when they're anxious, when they're excited, when they're nervous, when they're fearful. Give affection when they're calm. So then they associate this place with being calm.
To see him walk amongst other dogs in a calm, civilized manner is the whole goal. This is what we were trying to aim for, you know, the entire time with walking Lucky here in the complex.
So the more you know, the more confident you become, mm-hmm. the more knowledgeable you become, and that's what's going to make you a good pack leader.
Knowledge is power.
Knowledge is power. Shireen needs to work on her voice command. Right now, she's too soft. So I'm going to do something a little different. I'm sending her and Susan to a voice coach to work on putting some power behind her words when she's talking to Lucky. Then I want her to practice walking Lucky around the complex and all these dogs.
She has something to prove to this community so they can accept her and Lucky back. Thank you, everybody, for being awesome pack.
Thank you.
Yes.
Two weeks later, Cesar invites Shireen, Susan, and their neighbors to the Dog Psychology Center to see how Shireen handled her homework with Lucky.
I asked Shireen's neighbors to join us today because I want them to feel comfortable allowing Shireen and Lucky to be part of their community again. So how's it going in the neighborhood?
They're working with what you taught them, which is great. Yeah. In fact, you've got a little protege here. So she's using what the tools that you taught her.
Right.
Shireen is.
All right, let's see what you got. Did the boy lessons give you confidence?
Yeah.
I'm excited to see how it went.
So part of becoming more grounded when we speak is to learn to use our diaphragm. This is really going to help your voice have that power that's going to let Lucky know who's boss.
That's absolutely right.
Shh. Good. Again. Shh. From your diaphragm. Okay. Shh. Excellent job. Good work, ladies. Knock me over with your command. Get me to do what you want.
So off the couch.
Good. You even had a little attitude with it. I liked it. Nice.
We didn't realize we were so soft-spoken, but now we realize that we can be more assertive when it comes to commanding Lucky.
From when I started to now, I feel like I made leaps and boundaries, to be honest.
That's great. Now let's see how you did walking him around the complex. Nice. Tail is low, ears are slightly forward. Very good. There you go. Excitement here. There you go. Good redirection. Good timing.
If he looks at that dog, I correct him. Yeah. Like, I'm like, because I don't
perfect
want him to focus.
Timing.
Yeah.
That's it.
It's a world of difference, you know.
It's night and day for me.
Seeing from you is incredible.
To us, it's like a big, huge improvement. Mm-hmm. Not like before.
Before.
No, no, no. He's much better.
Good. That means we are much better.
Yes.
Okay. Shireen and Lucky are making progress. I think she's finally ready to walk Lucky in the dog parade. But she's going to have to focus on controlling him in the middle of so many distractions.
A few days later, Cesar meets Shireen and Lucky back at their home so he can watch Lucky in his neighborhood parade.
Well, as you know, you called me to help Lucky. I find out he is insecure. So that's what we have to help him with, his insecurity. So as you see in here, you have some dogs that get excited. And it doesn't help having a dog that is barking at Lucky at the same time. Right, so my point to this is every time, so you know how to be with Lucky because you want to help Lucky, is distance first, make sure both dogs are calm, and then you guys enter into a walking mode, not into a face-to-face mode. That creates fights. You know, I always say it takes a village to raise a dog, especially a village that has 75 dogs that all need to live in harmony. So everyone here needs to do their part to help Lucky so you guys can have a normal greeting or normal meeting. Now that the community knows what to do, it's time for Shireen to walk Lucky in their dog parade. That's my first parade!
Yay!
This is amazing! When I first got here, Shireen couldn't walk Lucky near another dog without him getting aggressive. Then, with the help of the gentle leader, she was able to get some control. Now, it's time to take the training wheels off. Let's go!
All right,
lead the parade.
All right, let's go.
So Cesar has Lucky in the front of the line, and that I'm feeling like kind of nervous, like, okay, like, is this going to go well?
Stay calm and confident.
As a community, myself and the rest of the ladies, the whole community, were afraid that they're going to regress into their old ways. With him biting dogs and humans, it's a huge concern of ours.
Coming up.
I've been rejected every day by this dog.
Can Jerry Seinfeld finally get along with Foxy? Cesar works with Shireen, who is leading her terrier mix Lucky in a dog parade for the first time.
That's my first parade!
Yay! Lucky has attacked other dogs and people before and must pass this final test or risk being kicked out of this dog-friendly community.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Nice.
Hey, sit. Calm. Sit. Sit.
Good job. That's exactly what I wanted to see. When Lucky acted out, Shireen immediately made a correction to change his focus away from the other dog. And she did it with a strong, authoritative voice.
Sit.
Then she made sure to follow through to bring him all the way to a calm state. Awesome.
Good job, guys. Good job. Nice. Very good.
Finally having Lucky to attend a dog parade for the first time, it was great. It was an emotion I didn't think I would ever get to feel because we were never invited to these parades.
Yeah. Good boy, Lucky. Good boy, good boy.
Watching how well-behaved Lucky was today, Lucky's absolutely welcome in the dog parade.
So, hey, back.
Nice. One of the things that we have to show to people, right, that it's not the dog. Everybody have to learn how to be with Lucky.
She's doing really good. Really, really, really good.
I never thought in a million years that we would get the training that we did.
Yes.
With the most popular dog trainer in the world. So it was a good experience.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your help.
Nice.
Thank you.
Very good. All right. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you so much.
Weeks later, Cesar returns to Jerry and Jessica Seinfeld's home to check on their progress with Foxy and Jose.
Very good.
Hi, Jose.
Much better. How are you?
How are you doing?
Good, and
Jose?
You?
Good. Good boy. Good girl.
That's right. When I entered Jerry's home, it was good to see Jose and Foxy just staying in their bed and not running towards the door.
Will you tell us how we did?
Yeah, I would love to. The first time I saw the Seinfeld dachshund, Jose, it was clear he was an excited dog that needed leadership, especially when the doorbell rings. Now I want to see how Jessica handled the homework. All right, let's take a look.
I see. It's a reaction.
Nice.
Go to your bed. Go to your bed.
That was great. When Jose got excited and began to bark, Jessica showed leadership and gave him the right command.
Go to your bed.
And he listened.
Calm.
Calm.
I like the silent part of it.
Yeah.
Now I want to see if Jerry and Foxy have formed a healthier bond. When I first met Foxy, she was an insecure dog that needed to learn to feel safe around people and, more importantly, around Jerry.
She got comfortable,
yeah,
and just, we just sat like that. Yeah. It was so nice.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. That's really good. She's not trying to run away.
There she came go. And she sat on my leg. Didn't even take 10 minutes.
It's there just nice not to be rejected, isn't it?
Yes, that is nice.
That's everybody's goal.
Yeah.
Yes, I've been rejected every day.
Every day.
By this dog.
Since we've got her, yeah, she has, yeah, rejected you. And yeah, this is such a nice change.
Yeah. I really feel great about my future relationship with Foxy. Because I know now how to relate to her. Yeah, this is really something very different right now.
Yeah.
In fact, I don't think this has ever happened.
No, we're like a family with two dogs. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It was a pleasure to help you and to help them more than anything. I'm going to go get me a dachshund now.
Are you?
I am. I'll send, right? you a picture. I'll send you a picture.
If you get a dachshund, we will die.
I'm going to name him Jerry.
That was a funny name for a dachshund.
Yeah, they're funny.
They're funny. That's why I knew it was a perfect dog for him.
Yeah. I am very proud of Jerry and Jessica. Because of their hard work, the Seinfelds are now enjoying a calmer, more balanced relationship with their dogs. And now all Seinfelds, including the dogs, couldn't be happier.
You really are.
Thank you so much.
You're a magician.
Thank you.
Oh,
it's been time with you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So such a great feeling to be with you.
Thank you. See you later, guys. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's go, Benson.